Welcome to the Startup Grind.
Thank you for coming tonight. It's a pleasure to see so many of you. My name is Elio. I run Startup Grind Cardiff, and we've got a fantastic speaker tonight. It's a pleasure to the quality of the speaker we have tonight. But before I start introducing the speaker, can I just say a few things about Startup Grind? Startup Grind is a community for startups where we empower startups to be credible in their businesses. So we always encourage entrepreneurs, and it's an organization run by entrepreneurs, for entrepreneurs, and it's sponsored by Google for Entrepreneurs as well. And we are the largest startup community in the world as well. So tonight the speaker is such an inspirational man, and he's been in Cardiff, he's part of Cardiff. So if you know Giovanni, you probably know the whole of Cardiff. That's how good he is. And he's got so many things, positives, which is there are so many things which I can't say, because he could say a whole book of the things I would like to say about Giovanni. But I'm so grateful that he accepted the invitation for tonight. And I'm so looking forward to speak to Giovanni and learn more, and I'm sure all the viewers will learn as well. So without further ado, can we please welcome Giovanni Malacrino. Thank you.
Thank you for supporting this evening. It's nice to support you as always. And I'm hoping that some of the stuff I share with you,
Giovanni, welcome.
Is it your camera working now?
Yes, it is. Yes,
it's
awesome.
Right.
Pleasure.
My pleasure. Pleasure. So let's get talking.
Yep.
So I want to share some stuff with you people. So,
right. Giovanni, it's a pleasure to meet you. And I've known you for quite some time now.
Yep.
So could you tell us more about your background, when you were born?
Well, I was born in Reggio Calabria. I came here when I was very young. There's a little bit of a confusion about my age, along with this 10-year difference here and there, so depends who I'm talking to. So I'm either 39 or 49. So I came here when I was 3, and I went to live in America. When I came here, I was very young, then I went back to Italy, then I went to America to work on cruise liners. And then I went up to open a restaurant in Colchester, New Jersey. And then came back to Cardiff because I missed sunny South Wales. And didn't have a clue what to do. I bought a little coffee shop called Planters. And it all started there, basically. But even when I went to America, I think in life, either you're an entrepreneur or you're not. So, to be an entrepreneur is taking risk. To be an entrepreneur is actually living outside your comfort zone, you know? To be an entrepreneur is doing things that people say won't work, and you make them work, you know? And it's getting rid of all borders, getting rid of all negativities, you know? And believing you're gonna make it happen. And that's what they did with America. I had a restaurant in America called the Fox and Hounds in Boston, New Jersey. Didn't have a clue. But one thing I always said to myself is, I don't know how, but I know I will. So I came to Cardiff, bought a little place called Planters, which was a little, in fact, before Planters, I remember I was going to buy the Sully Caravan Park, is it? Is it a caravan park in Sully?
Yes.
It was a little shop, and there was a caravan site there, and I done the deal, literally turned the deal, I don't know what you say, so Peter. So I did the deal, I was excited. I was about to own a little shop with a little cafe on a caravan site. So one day when I came back from shooting, I'd been on a clay video shooting, so I had my gun in my car. On the way home, I phoned the owner at the time, and I said to him, oh, I said, when are we exchanging the contract? He said, I've sold it. I said, no, I said, I bought it. He said, no, I've sold it. I said, but I bought it. And he went, no, I told somebody else. My world fell apart. Because it didn't work out, I thought it was all over. You know? I remember driving to this place with my shotgun in the back of the car, really thinking, I was so annoyed at the fact that this man who promised to sell me his business, right, wasn't going to sell it to me anymore. You know? And then that girl still said, listen, just act for a reason, just get back in the car, go home, you know, you'll be fine. Now, had I taken that business, then right now, I wouldn't have bought Giovanni's on Park Place. It's a guy called Brian Fry. Who knows Brian Fry? Well, Brian Fry at the time, he did a deal, he shook my hand, and other people then came over to try and offer him more money. And Brian Fry shook on it, he said it was mine, and he wouldn't sell it to yours. And I respect him for that. So we were a little place called Glanzer's, in a little coffee shop, and that was over 30 years ago. And all of a sudden, all we did was while our parents were the chips from the grain stand, we literally just cleaned it, had a bit of Italian food, and then when we made a bit of money, then we then turned it into Giovanni's restaurant, Now literally, within months, and I'll tell you why I'm telling this, within months, the place started getting busier and busier and busier. This is when I then started wishing, this is important, started wishing and dreaming and visualizing and praying that I had more space. We've got queues for our Giovanni's restaurant, and we couldn't see enough customers, enough quick enough, That was due to my sister Francesca, the staff, the food, the service. And all of a sudden, something happened. It was strange, One day I was praying for more space to put more tables in, and I dropped my keys, and the keys went under the stairs. When they went under the stairs, I looked with a torch and saw a room. What had happened, the previous owner, many before Brian Fry, years before, had a drink problem. So he built a wall and he threw his bottles over this wall. So when we took this wall out, we found a basement which we didn't realize we had. Now, had I not dropped my keys, had I not wished, had I not prayed, for more room, then the chances we would have grown any bigger. So I'm a big believer in the secret, in visualization, and in asking yourself what you want more than what you don't want, And I suppose because of that, because of my passion, my dream, my ambition, and all the hard work, and the fact that we care about staff, we care about customers, and the good thing that came out of it was the fact that, what we have now is Giovanni's restaurant, which is one of the busiest restaurants and the longest going restaurants in Cardiff.
Can I ask?
Yes, of course. So we just share last thing. So when I first opened it, people would say to me, "Is this your father's?" And I very proudly would say, no, this is mine. I opened it, it's my restaurant. Now they say to me, "Is this your restaurant?" And I say, "That was my father's." Just to lose a few years.
In terms of those times, which were, very hard for you, in terms of support, did you have support from your sister, from your family? What drove you? Was it to become rich? Was it to better yourself?
I was unemployable. Whenever I went to work, I'd drive them crazy. I'd always change things around and make things better. But sometimes managers that I worked with briefly, didn't like me to change because it was a deal. So I had great help from my sister Francesca, But the most important thing is getting people, staff, to believe in you, to believe in your product, and to want to work because it feels good, not just a job. If staff work for you because they feel excited, if staff work for you because they enjoy getting up in the morning, because to me in life, whatever you do, it shouldn't be painful. So, if you call it work as if in, I'm going to work, then get out of it. So the most important thing is ask yourself why you're doing what you're doing. Ask yourself why, you're doing that job. And if you don't like it, change it. But unless you know why you're doing it, get out of it. Do something different. You've got one life. That's what's important. The one life you've got to enjoy it. You've got to enjoy it. You've got to really sort of embrace it, So yeah, so support comes from the energy above and family and friends and customers.
I'm assuming your children also had a big part to play during those times when you had to come, so...
No, much. I don't know which one really meant.
Okay.
So, don't try to catch me on my ears. Off camera, I mean, so my children, which is the best thing that's ever happened to me, They came along after the restaurant, but they were very small. They were babies. So, but they were very good at helping spend it. But one thing I'll say, about my children is that there's a thing I say to people, you know, is teach them, don't give them. You know, sometimes people think because you give that they're going to be okay. You know, you mustn't just give. You've got to teach. There's a saying, give a man a fish, eats for a day. Teach him how to fish, or her how to fish, and eat for a lifetime. And it's so important you coach people, you teach people, you know, and not just give them. So
they have to work for it, yeah, which is great. And after those stages, what barriers did you face in here in South Wales which may help others in terms of the culture?
So if you imagine, I opened the restaurant, it's successful, and then I then went to buy a new restaurant, which I bought in Berlin. Now, you're saying, I'm going about visualization.